unique voice. It's what all guitar players are looking for, a way of putting your stamp on every musical message you send. What creates a unique voice? If you're a player, the answer lies in your head, your heart, your hand, and your instrument. It's all about the sound. It's what drew us into playing guitar in the first place, isn't it?
The sound of the guitar was so amazing. The thrill is like second to none.
The tone is just, it's incredible. It's gorgeous, and it's so deep and full sounding.
And I begged and I pleaded, and he went and asked the guitar teacher. No, 8 years old, too young to start playing guitar. I would not leave them alone, and until they finally allowed me to go take lessons, where I would play and my fingers would bleed, but I just wanted to play.
My first playing gig was with Uncle Boo and a guy named Clifton Colley. And we were playing at a forest festival in Prescott, Arkansas. Somebody took a snapshot of it. I got my guitar playing. I was about 13, I guess.
The first time I picked up a guitar was 1964. Same as a lot of people probably did, Beatles on Ed Sullivan. There's something struck a nerve deep. It was like something inside just turned on when I heard that sound, man.
When you hear that acoustic guitar playing, every time I record an acoustic guitar, I want to hear.
Every guitar player would agree, nothing moves you more than the sound of a great guitar. Ovation guitars have a unique voice that touches players across the broad spectrum in many different styles of music.
It's like a great acoustic guitar for guys that play electric guitar.
I started to pick and find a way to pick so that I could hit some of the octave strings and some of the lower strings, and because I was playing solo, I would hear drums and such in my head, and so I would do percussive things with the Ovation. The Ovation is the perfect thing to whack on and knock on, and you get all kinds of different sounds from it. And just purely out of necessity, I developed this style.
For me, since I do a lot of my playing up in a high register, to be able to get a pretty thick tone even up top.
The Adamus allows me to get, first and really most importantly, the tunings that I want. Because I really do love, I tune it almost to a baritone scale sometimes. It's really low, and the tone is still impeccable. Nothing is lost, even though the string tension is very loose. It can still, those really low bass notes resonate so well. And that, I think, is really more crucial to my style than people realize. Oh, and plus the light carbon fiber top. Everything you do, anytime you touch the top, it just, you know, has this incredible sound to it. So it really makes it really easy for me to, I don't really have to make much effort when I do the body percussion, because a lot of people think I'm really whapping on it, but I'm not. I'm merely just tapping, and because it's built, it's constructed so well, it's really easy to do that.
That's ringing the sound.
So I like the projection of the instrument. I like the way it pops. Other instruments don't do that for me. You don't have quite the same sensation that you feel in your gut. So that's part of the quality of the instrument, you know.
A big part of the Ovation sound is balance, and even tone and volume across all the strings over the entire fingerboard. It gives you a certain something you won't find in any other guitar.
The construction of the guitar itself and the way it handles inspires songs in itself, honestly, because I can't get that sound out of any other guitar. I couldn't play those songs in any other guitar, and I think that over the course of playing and writing and playing and writing, the guitar becomes the muse.
And yeah, it inspires me to write almost every time I sit down with it.
Ain't no use to sit and wonder why, babe. Don't matter anyhow. And ain't no use sitting and wonder why, baby. It don't matter anyhow. When the rooster crows at the break of dawn, look out the window and I'll be gone. You're the reason I'm traveling on. Now, baby, don't think twice, it's all right.
So, I mean, whatever the cool guys were playing, that's what we all wanted to play. So that's why I guess people come to the instrument. They see and they hear something and they go, I want to get that sound. Yeah, most of the sound is in the guy's hands and heart that's playing it, but you still, when you have a fine instrument, it only enhances that sound that much more.
So how did these players first discover Ovation?
Glen Campbell. There's no question about it. The first time I saw an Ovation guitar was Glen Campbell, and I was completely enamored by it, the way it looked. This had a different vibe to it. But I just saw just the motion of the hands and the way it sounded, how cool he looked playing it.
The first impression I had I think it was John McLaughlin had one. And I went to see him play. I think it was in my last year of high school. And right here in Hackensack, New Jersey, went to see him play. And he had this funny looking acoustic guitar with a round back. And I was very impressed with the sound. And of course, I wanted to check it out.
And I remember going into the music store, the one music store in Leavenworth, and talking to the guy, and I saw an Ovation 12-string, Sunburst 12-string on the wall. And I said, what's that? And I put it in my lap and started playing it. And it was so easy to play, and it fit. It was made for me. And I said, oh, and he allowed me to trade my guild back in for the Ovation, and I have played Ovation since then.
The first time I saw an Adamus, I believe, was Nancy Wilson from Heart. I saw her play it. I was playing with Boz at the 1977 Sony convention in London, and they were on the gig along with Weather Report, and we were like, I was in Boz's band, I was like 19 years old, watching, and they were great. I just remember this big fat sound coming from this really pretty girl.